take you to Nashville, Tennessee. Nashville Predators in the yellow at home. Vancouver Canucks on the road in white. Games in overtime. Series is 2-1 Vancouver, so it's either going to be 3-1 Canucks or 2-2 in this overtime. Let's see what happens.
Keeps the puck in on the near side. Joshua on the corner lets it go for Gurley. Centers, Lindholm scores! Elias Lindholm, 62 seconds into overtime, and the Canucks have done it. They're the eighth team in history to erase a two-goal deficit with under 2 minutes to go and win in overtime, and it's Lindholm the hero after Besser scored three in regulation.
Come back tonight.
Welcome to the Beers and a Rock Hall!
Greg the Egg, Blackmore Rules here. Hello from Canada. There's no snow here right now, yay! Anyway, this is from the DVD. Cross Purposes Live. And the only way you could get this at the time was you had to buy the CD, and it had a companion VHS, so you got to see the concert. This is one of the best concerts I've ever seen on DVD or video. Oh, you're throwing me more than the stupid Tony Martin era Sabbath 1994 Cross Purposes tour of that studio album. But Tony Martin sings every song really good, no matter if it's Oz era, Dio era, his era. Sound quality on this is fantastic. Geezer's there, Iommi's there. Bobby Rodinelli of Rainbow and Blues to Call Fame on drums. They've got a lot of other stuff to show you too, so. But I had to show the video here. Anyway, here's the track listing. Time Machine, every song's fantastic. And I don't know if I can't remember if the VHS had more songs than this. Because I know there's a DVD that came out with a few songs missing, but I don't know if it's this one or not. But anyway, I'll have to pause this and we'll get to the action. Go Canucks, go! As of filming this, they're up 3-2 in the series against Nashville in the Stanley Cup playoffs. Anyway, this is fantastic. If you love the Scorpions or like the Scorpions, you'll love this. 26 songs with Michael Schenker guesting, Billy John Roth guesting, Herman Rarebell guesting. This thing's excellent. The video, the sound, everything's. In fact, if you wanted one Scorpions item at all in your collection, this would do it. Because you even get like Speedy's Coming on there and We'll Burn the Sky. I mean, track this thing. But anyway, I gotta move on. I gotta show a bunch. Jimmy Live at Woodstock. I've only seen the part where he burns his guitar. I've never watched this whole concert before. I know Blackmore looks up to him, and everybody looked up to him. He still wins guitar polls and all, so I don't know. Maybe I'll finally sit down and just... Because, I mean, look at that picture. That's rock and roll. He's not just a guy who just stands there. Band of Gypsies. Hendrix Band of Gypsies. Oh, anyway, I gotta go fast. Here's a band I've hardly ever, I don't even know if I've ever watched one song by them live in concert. Live 1999. Says it's more like a movie. I don't know. I hope that doesn't mean they have interviews in between the songs or during the songs, even worse, but no booklet. Jeff Pilson, Red Beach, Don Dock, and Mick Brown. Oh, Okay, that's interesting lineup. Plus bonus acoustic tracks. Two songs. Ugh, I won't watch them, but speaking of Sabbath, live 2007, Radio City Music Hall in New York. I watched this when it came out, but I think I gave it away and I haven't watched it since, but all Dio era stuff. Computer Gods on there. Shadow of the Wind. So there must be some stuff off of the Dehuman. What? Yeah, it would. Off Dehumanizer 2, which I don't care for that album, but I love Mob Rules and Heaven and Hell, of course. But here's one I've never seen before. Play with Deep Purple for 20 years or so. Live 1990. I know he's supposed to be a great guitarist, but when I always compare him to Blackmore, and I just go, well, Richie wins, but... what year is this again? 90. It's got to be before he joined Purple, so I was hoping there'd be some Purple songs on there, but... it'll be interesting to find out what all the fuss is about with him anyway. That's why blondes should always have long hair, but Doro Live, two DVD set, Forever Para Simpy Re or something. Oops. Anyway, two DVDs. Flight, oh. Disc one, the cave concert, and then there's the video collection with it. Disc two, documentary, access all areas. Oh, the cover Born to Be Wild. Doro Meets the Symphony, I won't never watch that for $1 million. Now more access all areas. Well, that's quite the Doro package. Black Sabbath, when they had to name themselves Heaven and Hell. 30th anniversary interviews, Dio, Geezer, Vinny Appice, and Tony Iommi. Ronnie James Dio tribute from Geezer, Vinny, and Tony. Live in Europe. Yeah, Geezer Butler, man, is he unreal. Big, giant write-up. I saw them right around this time as well. At Sweden Rawk, live outdoors. That's the stage. I was way, way back there. So, but still sounded great. Dio Evil or Divine. So here's where you can get Black Sabbath, Rainbow, and Dio solo stuff. So I don't know why there aren't a ton of Dio tribute bands. If you could choose from Dio era Sabbath, the Dio era Rainbow, and Dio era Dio, it makes for the perfect show. Jimmy Bain on bass, Simon Wright on drums, Doug Ulrich on guitar. Can you see the track list? Yeah. Yeah, he did, Man on the Silver Mountain, that's good. Anyway. Now, this is Christian rock famous guy, Larry Carlton, but he's mellow. He's got electric guitar, though, but as far as I know, he's mellow. And this Steve Lukather or whatever, I can't remember where he's from. Oh, a Toto. A flamboyant guitar hero in his own right. 2001 get-together. Well, I was hoping Hold the Line would be on there, so I don't know if this is a rock DVD or mellow. I don't know. Anyway, two more. Ooh, how are we doing for time? Good. This is really good. Striper Live in Puerto Rico. I actually watched this on YouTube not too long ago. Now I just found the DVD. Live 2004 in Puerto Rico. Bonus material, rare archival live footage from 89, including Robert's drum solo, Keep the Fire Burning. Always there for you, Rockin' the World, and Tim and Oz's solos. On 53.5 Records. Good name for a record label. Obviously, they put it up themselves, I guess. And the last one. Holy Diver Live. I'm assuming it's all of Holy Diver done live. Might not be though. I think it is, because I don't remember all the names of the first Dio album, because I like about five songs I love, and then the rest I don't care about, but it starts out with Tarot Woman. That's a great opener, I mean, off of Rainbow Rising. Yeah, some good concert pictures. This is just... That's why Sabbath's just top three bands of all time. And when I listen to them a lot, I always think they're the number one, and then I go to Purple and I think they're number one. I'm sure you guys know how it is, but... I never did get to see Dio solo before. Track listing there, maybe. That's the way you do it. Concert pictures. Well, I guess that does it. So. Anyway, this is a must. You gotta get the Never Say Die DVD, live DVD from 78, the Never Say Die Tour. That's an ultimate must, and so is this. Those are the two big ones. Although the Live in Paris 70 is essential too, but... anyway, yeah, I guess I showed them all, so... chocolate milkshake time! Mm. Anyway, thanks for listening. Don't forget. Oh, what the heck? We'll get these out of the way. I've saved these for another episode, but I got through this quick enough. It's a CD and DVD. Region 12. I was going to look that up, but I haven't yet. Again, live from walking. That should be concert pictures, but whatever. Two CD, double CD, and DVD. Huge booklet. Anyway, the last one, the one I was just listening to in the car. Black Dog Parking. I've always had the studio album, but I didn't have the one with the live concert. So. I think it's eight songs, and it's about 45 minutes long, right off the soundboard at Walking Again. And it sounds fantastic. Might be too dark to see the track listing, but anyway, every song's excellent. The sound quality is excellent. Crowd, everything, the mix is excellent, so that's a must-have if you like AC/DC. This is better than AC/DC. I like it more than any AC/DC album after Back in Black. It's Black Dog Barking. And the Deep Live album is worth it just for price mission alone. Anyway, that's it. So thanks for listening. Don't forget, slower traffic. Keep lifting right. Cloudy. Right, Cloudy. Cloudy Stormy Mile or Metal Mogul. Check out his channel. That's in Scotland, that's why I say slower traffic, keep left or right, because I say slower traffic, keep right, Canada, but he says slower traffic, keep left. Anyway, bye-bye, Tony Iommi.